So GitHub has this new feature where you can display a README markdown file on your profile homepage. And today I want to show you how you can take full advantage of this new feature by automatically pulling in your latest content from YouTube or any other source using a free Netlify serverless function. So I had two reasons for doing this on my own profile. The first was to just make my GitHub profile a bit more exciting and a bit more dynamic. And secondly, I really wanted to learn a little bit more about serverless and to see how easy it would be to deploy some sort of backend logic that runs in a serverless context. So let's dive in. And be sure to like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe if you want to see more. So my example shows how you can do this for YouTube videos, but you can set this up to pull in your latest tweets or your latest blog posts or anything else you want to pull in. I'll let you use your creativity there. So let's take a look at how this works. First, when I upload a new video to YouTube, YouTube's going to fire off a webhook, which will call my Netlify function. And then in my Netlify function, I'll first fetch my three latest YouTube videos using the YouTube API. Then I'll generate some nice fancy thumbnails. And lastly, I will commit the thumbnails to my GitHub repo, as well as a new README that my Netlify function has generated. So it's as simple as that. So let's dive in. So what we're going to do in this video is take a look at the code that I wrote to do this. And I'm going to show you how you can set this up for yourself. If you want to skip ahead to the setup instructions and skip over the overview of the code, I have put timestamps in the description, so you can just skip ahead to the next section if you want to. So let's take a look at the code. You can see that we have a package.json and a functions folder. Now this functions folder is where all of your Netlify functions will sit that you can call. So we just have this one for now, which is YouTube README sync. But if you wanted to create another one that syncs to something else, you can just modify this code. So if we scroll all the way to the bottom, you can see that we have this exports.handler. And this is the function that gets called when you call the Netlify function. So this function is basically just going to call our run function for us. So our run function, first, it gets the latest YouTube videos for your channel. And you can see that these are the parameters that we pass in. So we say, give us the latest three videos for a specific channel. And we also pass in our Google API key, which we'll get to in a second. So then when we get the latest YouTube videos, we generate thumbnail images for all of them. So for each YouTube video, we download the thumbnail from YouTube. And then we use a library called Sharp to resize it and then give it a blur and then put an overlay over it and add rounded corners. So it takes a thumbnail that looks like this and turns it into something that looks like this, which I think is pretty cool. Next, we have some logic here, which fetches all of the assets in the assets directory of my personal GitHub repo. So we have this README, which is what appears on my profile page, but then we have the assets. And the assets right now are just these two thumbnail images. And then what we do is we go through each of the videos and upload the thumbnail images. And the way we name these thumbnail images is we just name these images by the order that the videos appear in this list. So the first one would be 0, the second one would be 1, and if I had another video in my channel, a third video, there would be a 2.png over here. So basically what we do is we just go through each of the videos and we'll determine what the path will be for that thumbnail. And then if there's already a file existing at that path, we're going to replace that file with our new image. Otherwise, if one doesn't exist, then we'll just create one. And what this allows us to do is no matter how many videos are added, we're not going to keep creating a new thumbnail image in this repo for each video. We're just going to keep replacing existing ones over here. And now we take all of our videos and we generate some markdown for each one. So you can see it's just an image and that image is wrapped in a URL which points to the video. And then we also have a bolded title with the link, which also points to the video. And then we have a new line and the date. And that gets rendered like this. And then we take all of our video rows and we join them. So between each video row, we put this blank image and that gives us a nice divider that separates the two. And you might ask, well, how do we know where to put these videos in the README? Well, if you look at the README, you can see that we have these two comments, YouTube list start and YouTube list end. So we've stored them here in variables, start comment and end comment. So what we do is we get the current README content from the GitHub repo, and we take everything before that start comment and everything after that end comment, and basically take out what's in between it. And then we replace what is in between these. And then once we have that new README content, we upload the new README content to GitHub. And it's really as simple as that. If we wanted to do this with some other content, you can just change this logic around a bit. So instead of fetching the latest YouTube videos from an API, you can fetch, for example, your latest Medium posts using the Medium API. And then you can fetch the medium thumbnails if you want to. And you can change around this markdown format over here to really work with the kind of content that you want to show. So let's actually set this up so that we can see how the whole thing works together. So to set this up for yourself, what you want to do is fork this repository so that it's on your GitHub account and you can make the edits yourself. And what you also want to make sure you have is a repository that is named the same as your username, right? So the repository will be github.com/your username/your username, right? And then add a README and make sure that the YouTube list start and YouTube list end comments exist. We don't have to have anything in between them. It can just be like this and they can sit anywhere within the README. So let me commit these changes. So now you can see that you don't actually see anything here because there's nothing in between those comments. Next, you want to go to Netlify and sign up for a free account and create a new site. Then you want to link your GitHub account with Netlify. And once you've done that, choose the dynamic GitHub profile repo. And then for the build command, you're just going to put in yarn. And all this is going to do is on build, it's just going to do your yarn dependency install. And now the next step is to set up environment variables. So let's have a look at the list of environment variables that you need for this. So GitHub repo is going to be the repo that we created earlier. So my username /my username. And then these two are your GitHub username and your GitHub access token, which is going to be a personal access token. And this is going to allow Netlify access to your GitHub repos. But I strongly recommend that you set up a special GitHub account and give Netlify access to that special GitHub account and not to your main account, because that personal access token will have full access to all of your GitHub repos. So what I've done is I've created a special GitHub account. Let's say my normal email address was name@example.com. I just added +bot to it. This is still a different email address to your normal email address, but emails sent to this account should come to your normal email. So you can see that in my main account, I've given my bot access only to this personal repo of mine. So now that my bot account has access only to my personal repo, let's head into settings for my bot account, head into developer settings and personal access tokens. And then we're going to generate a new token and we're going to give it a name and we're going to say that this token will have full access to our repos. And once we've generated the token, let's copy it and then just keep it somewhere like in a text file over here. And then your GitHub username is going to be the username of your bot account. Cool. So now we have our GitHub environment variable set up. Next is going to be your YouTube channel ID. And if you're just following along, you can just use my YouTube channel ID. Next is going to be the Google API key. So to get a Google API key, head over to console.developers.google.com and create a new project. So I've just called it Netlify Serverless. Then you want to head over to credentials, and in credentials, you want to say create credentials and API key. This just allows you to access public Google resources, like someone's public uploads to their channel. This just kind of tells Google who you are to make sure that no one sort of anonymous makes any requests to them. Okay, so now that we have that Google API key, let's just store that somewhere as well in a notepad. So now that we have all of our environment variables added, and again, keep in mind that these two are secret, so you don't want to share them with anyone, but they will be safe if you keep them in Netlify. So now let's click deploy site. So normally with Netlify, if you deploy a site, you actually are deploying a website, like a static site. But here we don't actually have a website that we're deploying. We're just deploying a function. And we're going to go to our function settings. And then we're going to edit the settings here and say that the functions directory, so the place that they can find our functions, is just going to be functions, right? Because that's where we stored our Netlify function. Now, once we've saved that, we need to go back here to Netlify, go to our deploys, and we're going to trigger a new deploy, because now that we have our functions directory set up, with this deploy, it's going to find our function and deploy that for us. Here you can see that it's packaging functions from the functions directory, and there it is, setting it up. So now that our function is published, let's head over to functions, and here you can see our function is listed, and here is the endpoint for our function. So let's copy this endpoint. Let's open up a tool like Postman, or you can use curl if you want to. And we're gonna make a post request to our serverless function. Might take a few seconds because obviously it has to download images and process them and upload them to GitHub. But if all is well, we should get an okay response over here. So now if we head back to our username/username repo, and if you look at the commit history, you can see that our Jacques Blom bot committed add thumbnail and add thumbnail to add the two thumbnails, and it committed to update the videos table. So it added in our videos table over here between the start and the end. And now if we head back to our profile, you can see that our latest videos have pulled in. So this is really cool, but it still means that we have to call this function whenever a new video is uploaded. To automate that, we can set up a webhook. So we're going to head to pubsubhubbub.appspot.com/subscribe, which is Google's webhook service, which looks like it's from the 1990s. And for the callback URL, we're going to put in our serverless function. And for our topic URL, we're going to put in this URL with our channel ID. And we're going to leave everything as default and click do it. If all went well, you should just see a white screen, which is okay. Whenever you upload a new YouTube video, YouTube is going to call your Netlify function and it's going to automatically update your README. And that is how you can make your GitHub profile super dynamic and way more exciting. Thanks for watching. Thanks for making it all the way to the end. And if you enjoyed this, please give it a like and subscribe if you want to see more.